motor driven, equipped with a 17 to 85 zoom lens, is a good silent camera for documentary, sports, and public relations projects. It also has an input for tape recording. Sound filming is done on a self-blimped 400-foot Oricon, capable of optical or magnetic sound sync filming. This camera is equipped with a CinePro noise reduction galvanometer for best quality optical sound recording. When making animations or titles, a Kodak Cine2 Special is used with its cable-controlled shutter release, reflex editor. All splices are made from tape so they can... When it is time for editing, this KLM fingertip sound editing board makes any sequence as easy as pressing a button. With its 8x10 viewing screen, the operator can get a true feel for the action. A optical and magnetic Calhart Victor projector has a cortex immediately after shooting. Omega does its own duplicating on the superior contact duplicating. Both prints are top quality. Besides 16mm, which is our specialty, Omega has a complete line of Super 8 sound equipment. A sound striping machine for Super 8 enables sound to be added to silent film in a matter of minutes. But when slides or prints are called for, we are ready, having complete darkroom facilities. Special techniques are used. Slides
is tape only. The tape is useful when you want to break your splices apart. Glue is almost never used, only in amateur work. We always use tape splices. We try to always shoot in negative film unless we have a call for the reversal. But first we get our negative original film. We take it here. This is an optical sound producer, and we get our sound back and our picture here. We splice it and we get ourselves our finished master copy. After having a master copy in negative, we're ready to run one of our release prints. There's other techniques we could use, but this here is a technique in which we use for our release prints. We use a duplicating machine, which is over here. As you can see, you put your original material on the top and your duplicating film goes on the bottom. Then the film is ran through here. We have a soundtrack and we also have a picture exposure meter, which work about the same as the camera and
the lamp. This projector is capable of single frame, reversible, and stop action. These features make adding magnetic sound precise to the frame. Omega also has a 16mm continuous process machine, which enables it to process camera stocks and duplicate stocks.
Back to being the same quality. IBM and AT&T. No sense talking about it here, but now we're looking at it. This is the processing machine, and the design was basically totally my own, and it's functional. I've gotten a lot of film out of it, and it seems to get better and better. Right now it's black and white reversal I'm doing on it. It, for my sound movies, this is about the most expensive piece of equipment I have, and it works well and suits my purposes. It gives me the sound that I need, and it gives me a permanent
soundtrack.
What frequency you can see it? There it picks out.
We're at Rutgers University, ladies and gentlemen, with Professor Thomas Del Paso. He's a research chemist and physicist here at Rutgers University. Tommy's familiar with the Epis Descender because he's a follower of the station. He's also a pop music lover also. And he was just checking out some of our equipment. Every time he sees a piece of equipment, he just tuned up all our sound equipment.
The kit that you take on the bill, and he's going to install in his car on a Plymouth, an 8-cylinder Plymouth. Tom, how does that thing work? How does it save your points?
How does it save your points?
Through this transformer. In conjunction with these transistors, it acts as commutators to drive the transformer. This transformer charges up this big condenser over here, which holds 400 volts that the chip produces, and all these other things that control the switching. In the back here, there's a silicon controlled rectifier.
It's 1.5 amps, something like that.
No, 7 amps.
At 10,000 RPM.
And this increases the voltage of the spark plugs by how much? By 5 times? No, by...
I guess there is.
Welcome to the laboratory. This is where we produce the chemicals to develop the movie. We're going to make an experiment today so you can learn how to make hydrogen. Hydrogen is an element. It's very simple to make. We use aluminum, and in here, which is the heater, we have some hot water mixed with lye. Well, first we get the aluminum and we put it inside this flask. After having the aluminum inside there, we add the lye. Very careful, lye is a very dangerous substance. Now, as you can see, we're getting a nice good bag full of hydrogen here. And we're not using that much. If you ever do this experiment, I suggest you get a bigger bag.
Movie is going to be about processing done continuously in a rubber machine that I constructed, which is over here. This machine takes the magazines from the camera and uses the rewind film and it feeds into the machine. We're going to take it apart and we'll take a look at the interior. Here's the interior of the machine, and as you can see, the processing is done inside of these tubes. These tubes are filled with chemicals. They have a small heater at the bottom. They take a gallon each, and they expose about 5 foot of film to a particular chemical which is in them. Here we have 4 tubes in here. This machine is being ready for reversal, but now is in the processation, which goes through these hoses and is done with air bubbles. The air bubbles come out of this unit here, and it's an air compressor, and it has a timer attached to it. The timer sets the air compressor off for about 5 seconds every minute. Then the film is cleaned in this tub, dried inside of this tube, and rewound here on the take-off wheel. Now, for the next shot, we'll come around here and we'll take a look at the driving mechanism.